3-6, finding the percent of a number mentally. Now, before we get too deep into this, I need to make sure we understand something. Even though the lesson says that you are doing, let me get my marker to work here. There you go. Even says we're doing it mentally, I want you to kind of scratch that concept out of your head. Because although I'm teaching you a mental math technique, I still expect you to show your work. You have to prove to me that you understand the mental math technique that we're using. Just throwing down the answer because you did it mentally will receive you a big fat goose egg. Okay? Moving forward, you can use percents such as 50%, 10%, and 1% to find other percents mentally. 50% of a number is also known as one half of a number. That ought to be pretty obvious and easy, which means one half times the number. Remember, the word of is a mathematical word that means times. Anytime you see the word of, you're multiplying. So say you wanted 50% of 250, that's the same thing as one half times 250, because of means times. Here you can change that 250 to an improper fraction by putting a 1 under it, simplify, and multiply, or you can multiply first and then simplify. Either way, 125 would be your final answer. This, of course, is showing your work. I must see all of it. 10% of a number is known as 1/10 of a number. And this is one of the things that come in really handy when you're trying to tip a waitress or when you're out shopping and it says 30% off. You can use this 10% rule to find out how much something actually costs very quickly in your head. Say, for example, you have 10% of 270. Of course, means times, so we're going to change that to times. And then the 10% rule says all you have to do is bounce the decimal one place to the left. So 10% of 270, 27. Circle your answer. Wow, that was hard. And the 1% rule is 1/100th of a number. Change your of to times. 1% times 270. The 1% rule says you bounce the decimal two spaces to the left, so it's going to be 2.7. That's all there is to it. Easy. The fun comes when you start mixing it together to come up with some percent values using several different approaches to get to them. Like this one here. We're going to use mental math and we want to find out what 60% of 480 is. And there's a couple of ways we can go about it. One way we could do is start off by saying, well, 50% of 480 is equal to 240, because that's half. And then we can say 10% of 480 is equal to 48. That's using that decimal bounce rule right there. And then 50 plus 10, add them up. That's going to give us 60% of 480. Add these up. It's going to be 288. Boom, right there. So you could circle that answer and be done, or we can move it on. Let's look at it another way. Another way you could go about this is just using the 10% rule. 10% of 480 is 48. Multiply both sides by 6. 10% times 6 is 60%. 48 times 6 is 288. Either way, your answer is going to be the same. You take a minute, pause the recording, and use your mental math rules to find 5% of 400. Alrighty, for this one, I would use the 1% rule as a starting point. Oops, maybe not. Maybe I'll use the 10% rule as a starting point. I'd say that 10% of 400 is going to equal to 40, but I don't want 10%, I want 5%. What's the relationship between 5% and 10%? Well, 5% is 1/2 or 50% of 10%. So now I'm going to say the 50% of the 10% value, which was a 40 right there, is going to give me my 5% that I'm looking for, otherwise known as 20. Another way you could do it, the way I thought I was going to go first, use the 1% rule. 1% of 400 is 4. Multiply both sides by 5, and you get 5% of 400 is 20. That's all there is to it. Easy math. Pause recording again. Try that one out for size. Alrighty. Here you got 70% of 600. Once again, there's several ways to skin this kitty cat. Meow. One option, the way I would prefer to use on this one, would be 10% of 600 is going to be 60. From there, multiply both sides by 7, and we find 70% of 600 is 420. And a place that you may find this is you may see that there's this television set that you want that is 30% off. And you want to say, well, if it's 30% off of 600, how much am I really paying? Well, you take the 30%, subtract it from 100, and that's where the 70% came from. Use your 10% rule to get to 70% of 600, and you find that that $600 TV is now $420, and that's probably a pretty good deal. A restaurant bill is $42. You leave a tip of 15%, which incidentally that means you are either cheap or you had a bad server, because the general rule, a restaurant today, you're going to want to leave a 20% tip if you have a good server. If your server is really kind of pitiful, then you only give them 10%. And if they're just so-so, that's where that whole 15 comes in. Remember, servers don't get paid much. Back when I was in college waiting tables, I got paid, as I recall, something like $2.50 per hour. That was it. Oh, my remote's rebooting here. Hold on. And there it is. Oh, per hour. But I also made tips. And I was pretty darn good. Believe it or not, I know how to be nice to people if they're going to pay me to be nice to them. So I would usually get at least the 20% tip, if not higher, and I'd walk home every night with well over $100 in my pocket just from working about a six to eight hour shift. So that's not too terribly bad for waiting tables, particularly back in that day and time. Remember, that was, let's see, is the time of this recording 15 years ago? 16, 17 years ago. So $100 a night back then, that was doing pretty good waiting tables. Here we're going to say, well, first off, let's find out what 10% of the $42 is. That'll, of course, be $4.20 using the 10% rule. And then I need to find out what 5% of it's going to be to put it all together. 5% is, of course, half of the 10%. I took my 10% value, right, let me get my thing, mouse back here again. I took my 10% value of 420, found half of that, because half of that is the same thing as saying 5% of $42, okay? Yeah, got a dollar sign there. Half of 420 is going to end up being 210. Now we can take and add those together. The 420 plus a 210 equals $6.30. So on a $42 bill, a 15% tip, you'd be tipping your waiter or waitress $6.30. Your opportunity to expand your mind tonight is actually coming out of an old workbook from years ago when I first started teaching. It's workbook page 8-4.
At the river mouth, the bears catch only the tastiest, most tender salmon. Which is exactly what we at John West want.
Oh, look, an eagle!
John West endure the worst to bring you the best.
Thank you. play.